The following is a recorded Friday sermon by the Sheikh Muhammad ibn Salih Al Uthaymeen. It is entitled The Message of Tawheed.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى بالهدى ودين الحق فبلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.
Verily, all the praise is for Allah. We praise Him, we seek His aid, we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil of ourselves and from the evil consequences of our actions. Whosoever Allah guides, there's none that can misguide him. Whosoever Allah misguides, then there's no guidance for him. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah. He is one, having no equals. And I bear witness that Muhammad is the slave and messenger of Allah. Allah, who Ta'ala, has sent him with guidance and the religion of truth. So he conveyed the message, and he discharged the duty, and he advised the nation. He strove jihad in Allah's cause, the actual and true jihad. So may the prayers of Allah and His peace be upon him, and upon his family, and upon his companions, and those who follow them in truth until the day of recompense. As to proceed.
أما بعد فيا أيها الناس اتقوا الله تعالى واشكروه على نعمه العظيمة التي أجلها وأفضلها وأسعدها في الدنيا والآخرة ما أنعم به عليكم حين بعث فيكم رسولا من أنفسكم يتلو عليكم آياته ويزكيكم ويعلمكم الكتاب والحكمة بعد أن كان الناس في ضلال مبين. رسولاً أخرج الله به من الظلمات إلى النور، من ظلمات الجهل إلى نور العلم، ومن ظلمات الشرك والكفر إلى نور التوحيد والإيمان، ومن ظلمات الجور والإساءة إلى نور العدل والإحسان، ومن ظلمات الفوضى الفكرية والمنهجية إلى نور الاستقامة في الهدف والمنهج، ومن ظلمات القلق النفسي وضيق الصدر إلى نور الطمأنينة وانشراح الصدر. قال الله عز وجل: لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. المعنى وإنهم كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين.
O mankind, as to proceed, O mankind, fear Allah the Exalted and thank Him for His immense bounties, the most majestic of which, the best of them, and the most expansive of them, in the dunya and in the next life, which He has bestowed upon them, is when He sent amongst you a messenger from amongst yourselves, reciting to you his verses, purifying you, and teaching you the book and the wisdom, al-hikmah, after the people were in clear misguidance. A messenger by which Allah, He brings the people out from darkness to light, from the darkness of ignorance to the light of knowledge, and from the darkness of shirk and disbelief to the light of tawheed and faith. From the darkness of oppression and iniquity to the light of justice and goodness. From the darkness of confusion in the mentalities and the methodologies to the light of al-istiqama and uprightness in objectives and methodology. From the darkness of grief in the soul and tightness of the chest to the light of contentment and expansiveness of the chest. Allah Azza wa Jal has said, Verily Allah has bestowed a favor upon the believers when He sent amongst them a messenger from amongst themselves, reciting to them His verses, purifying them, and teaching them the book and al-hikmah. And the people were, prior to that, in clear misguidance. The meaning of it is, and they were, before the sending of the messenger, in clear misguidance.
أيها الإخوة، اشكروا الله على هذه النعمة التي بها سعادتكم في الدنيا والآخرة وراحتكم وطمأنينتكم. يقول الله تعالى: الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. اللهم اعمر قلوبنا بذكرك حتى تطمئن وتنشرح صدورنا. وقال الله عز وجل: أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه، يعني كمن لم يكن كذلك. لا والله لا يستويان. فمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه، فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله، أولئك في ضلال مبين. وقال الله تعالى: كتاب أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور بإذن ربهم إلى صراط العزيز الحميد. الله الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض، وويل للكافرين من عذاب شديد. الذين يستحبون الحياة الدنيا على الآخرة ويصدون عن سبيل الله ويبغونها عوجا، أولئك في ضلال بعيد.
O brothers, thank Allah the Exalted for this bounty, by which is your happiness in the dunya and the next life, and your rest and your contentment. Allah the Exalted says, Those who believe and whose hearts find contentment in the remembrance of Allah, verily by the remembrance of Allah do the hearts find contentment. O Allah, cultivate our hearts upon your remembrance until they are content and our chests are expanded. And Allah the Exalted says, Is then he who Allah opens his chest to Islam so that he is upon light from his Lord. The meaning of that is he like the one who is not like that? No, by Allah, the two are not equal. For he who Allah opens his breast to Islam, he is upon light from his Lord. So woe to those who have hard hearts from the remembrance of Allah. These are they who are upon clear misguidance. And Allah the Exalted said, A book we have revealed to you so that you may take the people out from darkness to light by the permission of their Lord, to the straight path of Al-Aziz Al-Hamid, the Almighty, one who is worthy of praise. Allah is he for whom belong the heavens and whatever is in the earth. So woe to the disbelievers from a punishment that is severe. Those who prefer the life of the dunya over the akhirah, and they hinder men from the path of Allah, and they seek to make it crooked. These are those who are in clear misguidance.
لقد بعث الله تعالى نبيه محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، والناس يتخبطون في الجهالات والضلالات، ففتح لهم أبواب العلم من كل وجه حتى يصلوا إلى أسمى الغايات. فتح لهم أبواب العلم بالله عز وجل وبما له من الأسماء الحسنى والصفات الكاملة العليا والأفعال التي مبناها على الحكمة والغاية الحميدة، وما له جل وعلا من الحقوق وإخلاص التوحيد له. وفتح لهم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم أبواب العلم في عالم الكون في مبدئه ومنتهاه والغاية منه والحساب والجزاء. قال الله تعالى: وما خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما إلا بالحق وإن الساعة لآتية فاصفح الصفح الجميل. وقال الله تعالى: وما خلقنا السماء والأرض وما بينهما باطلا ذلك ظن الذين كفروا فويل للذين كفروا من النار. أم نجعل الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات كالمفسدين في الأرض أم نجعل المتقين كالفجار؟ وقال الله تعالى: وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون، ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون، إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. وقال الله عز وجل: ولقد خلقنا الإنسان من سلالة من طين، ثم جعلناه نطفة في قرار مكين، ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة، فخلقنا العلقة مضغة، فخلقنا المضغة عظاما، فكسونا العظام لحما، ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر، فتبارك الله أحسن الخالقين. ثم إنكم بعد ذلك لميتون، ثم إنكم يوم القيامة تبعثون.
Allah the Exalted has sent His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while the people were steeped in ignorance and misguidance. So He opened for them the doors of knowledge from every direction until they arrived at the highest of objectives. He opened for them the doors of knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal and what He has of beautiful names and perfect attributes of highness and actions. And actions which are predicated upon wisdom and the highest level of praise, and what He Jalla wa Ula has of rights and sincerity of tawheed to Him. He opened for them the doors of knowledge of the creation, its beginning, its end, its apex, the reckoning, and the recompense. Allah the Exalted says, "And we have not created the heavens nor the earth and what is in between them except in truth. Verily the hour is indeed coming, so prepare for it with a good preparation." And Allah the Exalted said, "And we have not created the heavens and the earth and what is between them in batil, meaning in falsehood. That is the assumption of those who disbelieve. So woe to those who disbelieve from a fire. Or are we to make those who believe and do righteous actions like those who cause mischief and corruption in the earth? Or are we to treat the muttaqin, the pious ones, like the fujar, the evil sinners?" And Allah the Exalted said, "And I have not created the jinn and mankind except that they should worship me, nor do I seek from them that they should provide for me, nor do I seek from them that they should feed me. Verily Allah, He is Ar-Razzaq, He is the ever-providing, the one who has strength and might." And Allah, the Mighty and Majestic, said, "Verily we have created mankind from sounding clay, and then we made him to be a nutfa, mixed drops of male and female sperm, and placed them in a firm lodging. And then we made the nutfa to be an alaqa, a clot. And then we made the clot to be a mudghah, a lump of flesh. And then we made the mudghah and we made it into bones. And then we clothed the bones with flesh. And then we have brought him forth as a new creation. So blessed be Allah, the best of the creators. And then you, after that, you will die. And then after that, you will be raised up on the day of recompense."
فانظروا أيها الإخوة كيف ذكر الله في هذه الآيات العظيمة مبدأ هذا الكون وغايته ومنتهاه. من أين لكم هذا العلم إلا من طريق محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ وفتح الله تعالى فتح الله ببعثة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبواب العلم في عبادة الله عز وجل والسير إلى رضوانه ودار كرامته، فبين لهم كيف تكون العبادة ومتى تكون العبادة وأين تكون، وفتح لهم أبواب العلم في معاملة الخلق ناطقه وبهيمه. فما من شيء ناطقه وبهيمه، وفتح لهم أبواب العلم في طلب الرزق واستخراج ما أودعه الله في الأرض من كنوز الذهب والفضة وغير ذلك. فما من شيء يحتاج الناس إلى معرفته من أمور الدين والدنيا إلا بيّنه لهم أتم بيان. قال الله تعالى: ونزلنا عليك الكتاب تبيانا لكل شيء وهدى ورحمة وبشرى للمسلمين. فكان الناس ولله الحمد بعد بعثة هذا النبي الكريم كانوا على محجة بيضاء لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك، ولا يتيه فيها إلا أعمى القلب.
So look, O brothers, how Allah has mentioned in these great verses the beginning of this creation, its apex and its ending. From where did this knowledge emanate except by way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? And Allah opened the doors by the sending of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam of knowledge and the worship of Allah azza wa jal, and the paths to his good pleasure and the noble home in the hereafter. So he clarified for them how, when, and where to worship Allah. He opened for them the doors of knowledge concerning the dealings with the creation, the human of them and the animal of them. So there is nothing from the creation, whether it be a human or an animal, except that Allah opened for them the doors of knowledge concerning how it is to seek its sustenance and abstract that which Allah has placed for it in the earth, such as the treasures of gold and silver and other than that. So there is nothing which the humans need to have knowledge of from the affairs of the religion and the dunya except that he has clarified it for them in the most perfect of clarifications. Allah the Exalted has said, and we have sent upon you a book as a clarification for everything, and a guidance and a mercy and a glad tiding for the Muslims. So the people were, and for Allah is the praise, after the sending of this Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they were upon clear brightness. None deviates from it except the one who is destroyed, and no one strays concerning it except the one who has a blind heart.
قال أبو ذر رضي الله عنه: لقد توفي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وما طائر يقلب جناحيه في السماء إلا ذكر لنا منه علما. فالحمد لله على نعمه، والحمد لله على ما آتانا من فضله. أيها الإخوة، بعث الله نبيه محمدا صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وأكثر الناس منغمسون في الشرك، فمنهم من يعبد البشر، ومنهم من يعبد الشجر، ومنهم من يعبد صنما ينحته بيده، ومنهم من يعبد حجرا يلتقطه من الأرض، حتى قيل إن الواحد منهم إذا سافر فنزل منزلا التقط أربعة أحجار، فوضع ثلاثة منها تحت القدر، ونصب الرابع إلها يعبده. وقيل إن بعضهم يعجن من العجوة من التمر شكلا على صنم فيعبده، فإذا جاع أكله. أترون جهلا أعظم من هذا الجهل؟
أبو ذر، may Allah be pleased with him, said, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, and there was not a bird which flapped its two wings in the sky except that he mentioned to us some type of knowledge concerning it. So the praise is for Allah for his favors, and the praise is for Allah for what he has given us from his bounty. O brothers, Allah has sent his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while the majority of the people were of different categories concerning shirk. So from amongst them was he who worshipped human beings, and amongst them were he who worshipped a tree, and amongst them was he who worshipped an idol which he had fashioned with his own hand, and amongst them was he who worshipped stones which he had picked up from the earth. This is to the point that it has been said that one from amongst them, when he was traveling and he would descend at a particular place, he would pick up four stones from the earth, place three of them under his cooking pot, and he would erect the fourth one as a god and worship it. And it has been said that some of them, they would press or knead wet or moist dates into the image of an idol and worship it, so that if he became hungry, then he would eat it. Have you seen ignorance greater than this ignorance?
لكن الله عز وجل أنقذهم ببعثة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم من هذه الهوة السحيقة والسفه البالغ من عبادة المخلوق إلى عبادة الخالق، فحققت التوحيد تحقيقا بالغا وذلك بأن تكون العبادة لله وحده لا شريك له، يتحقق فيها الإخلاص بالقصد والمحبة والتعظيم، فيكون العبد مخلصا لله في قصده، مخلصا لله في محبته، مخلصا لله في تعظيمه ظاهرا وباطنا. قال الله تعالى لنبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم: قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له، وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين. هكذا أمر الله، هكذا أمر الله في كتابه، هكذا أمر الله تعالى في كتابه أن يقول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له، وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين. ولهذا جاءت السنة النبوية المطهرة مبينة لكتاب الله تعالى في حماية هذا التوحيد وسد كل طريق يوصل إلى نقصه أو نقضه. فروى النسائي عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما أن رجلا قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم: ما شاء الله وشئت. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم منكرا عليه: أجعلتني لله ندا؟ ما شاء الله وحده. فأنكر النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، أنكر على هذا الرجل أن يقرن مشيئة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بمشيئة الله بحرف يقتضي التسوية بينهما، وجعل ذلك من اتخاذ الند لله عز وجل، واتخاذ الند لله تعالى شرك بالله سبحانه.
However, Allah the Mighty Majestic saved them by the sending of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from this stupidity and this extreme foolishness, from the worship of the creation to the worship of the Creator, so that Tawheed is actualized, and it is that the worship before Allah alone and no partners be associated with Him. This is actualized by sincerity and intention, love and ta'zim or magnification, so that the slave, he be sincere to Allah in his intention, sincere to Allah in his love, and sincere to Allah in his glorification of him, outwardly and inwardly. Allah the Exalted said concerning his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, verily my prayer, my sacrifice, my living, my dying are all for Allah, Lord of the Alameen. He has no partners. With that I have been commanded, and I am the first of the Muslims. Likewise, Allah the Exalted has commanded his prophet in his book that he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, verily my prayer, my sacrifice, my life, my death are all for Allah, Lord of the Alameen. With this I have been commanded, and I am the first of the Muslims. Due to this, the Sunnah, the prophetic pure Sunnah, has come as a clarification to the Book of Allah the Exalted in protection of this concept of Tawheed, and as a blocker to the means of Shirk, all those means which lead to its diminution or its nullification. And Nasa'i has narrated on the authority of Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with them both, that a man said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what Allah wills and what you will. So he, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said to him in repudiation of him, do you make me as a rival to Allah? Rather, what Allah wills only. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repudiated this man for connecting the Mashiach, or the will of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to the will of Allah, with this harf, this word which necessitates equality between them, and he considered that to be taking him as a rival to Allah the Mighty and Majestic, and taking a rival for Allah the Exalted is shirk with Allah the Glorified.
قريب من ذلك ما يكتبه بعض الجهال في لوحات يعلقها أو في بعض الساعات الحائطية يكتب اسم الله من الجانب الأيمن واسم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم من الجانب الأيسر بصف متساوي، فإن الناظر إليهما من الجهال والعوام يظن أنهما في مرتبة واحدة، لذلك نرى أنه يجب المسح عليهما حماية لجانب التوحيد وابتعادا عن الشرك، والشرك يكون خفيا وربما يسري إلى القلب من حيث لا يشعر الإنسان. فاتقوا الله عباد الله وابتعدوا عما يخل بالتوحيد وفروا منه فراركم من الأسد.
Worse than that, even worse than that, is what some of the ignorant people write in the notebooks connecting the two, or on some of the clocks which hang upon the walls, writing the name of Allah from the right side and the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the left side on one equal line, so that if the one looking at it is from the ignorant people or from the common folk, he thinks that they are of the same level. Due to this, we hold that it is obligatory to erase them out of protection for the concept of Tawheed and staying away from Shirk. And Shirk, in this matter, it is inconspicuous. Perhaps it creeps into the heart from where one does not perceive it. So fear Allah, O slaves of Allah, and stay away from that which nullifies or violates this Tawheed. And flee from it. Flee from it like you flee from a lion.
وروى النسائي أيضا بسند جيد أن ناسا جاءوا إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم فقالوا يا رسول الله، يا خيرنا وابن خيرنا وسيدنا وابن سيدنا، فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم يا أيها الناس قولوا بقولكم ولا يستهوينكم الشيطان، أنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله، ما أحب أن ترفعوني فوق منزلتي التي أنزلني الله عز وجل. وهذا مع أنه صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم سيد بني آدم وخير بني آدم بلا شك، ولكنه صلى الله عليه وسلم خاف أن يستهويهم الشيطان فيوقعهم في الغلو حتى يرفعوه إلى منزلة الخالق، فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم إنه عبد الله ورسوله حماية لجانب التوحيد وسدا لطرق الشرك وبيانا للحقيقة والمنزلة التي هي أعلى منازل البشر وهي العبودية لله عز وجل والرسالة. وروى الإمام أحمد وابن ماجه والترمذي وحسنه عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه قال قال رجل يا رسول الله، الرجل منا يلقاه أخوه أو صديقه أينحني له؟ قال لا. قال فيلتزمه ويقبله؟ قال لا. قال فيأخذ بيده ويصافحه؟ قال نعم.
النسائي also narrated with a good chain of narration that a people came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and they said, O Messenger of Allah, O best one from amongst us, O son of the best one from amongst us, O our master, O son of our master. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O people, say your statement, but do not let the shaitan deceive you. I am Muhammad, the slave of Allah and his messenger. I do not love that you place me above the station which Allah has placed me in. This is in addition to the fact that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is actually the leader of the children of Adam and the best of the children of Adam without doubt. However, he sallallahu alayhi wasallam feared that the shaitan would deceive them so that they would fall into al-ghulu or extremism and excessiveness to the point that they raise him to the level of the creator. So he sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that he is the slave of Allah and his messenger out of protection for this concept of tawheed, blocking those means which lead to shirk, and as a clarification to the reality of the affair and the station which is the greatest or the highest and most exalted of the stations that a human being could reach, and it is the station of servitude to Allah Azza wa Jal and messengership. And Imam Ahmad Ibn Majah and At-Tirmidhi also narrated, and At-Tirmidhi declared it to be hasan, or good, on the authority of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, that he said that a man said, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, amongst us is he who, when he meets his brother or his friend, that he bows to him. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, do not do this. He said, so how about if he meets him and he hugs him and he kisses him? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, do not do this. So he said, well, how about if he takes his hand and he shakes it? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, nah, do this.
وقال الشعبي رحمه الله كان أصحاب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا التقوا تصافحوا فإذا قدموا من السفر عانق بعضهم بعضا فمنع النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم من الانحناء عند التسليم لأن ذلك خضوع للبشر قد يكون وسيلة إلى تعظيم غير الله بالركوع والسجود وكان السجود عند الملاقاة من باب التحية جائزاً في بعض الشرائع السابقة ولكن هذه الشريعة شريعة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم خاتم النبيين منعت منه سواء كان من أجل التحية والإكرام أم من أجل التذلل والخضوع أيها الناس إن على الإنسان أن يراعي جانب التوحيد ويعرف للخالق حقه فلا ينقصه ولا يشرك به معه غيره لا باللفظ ولا بالفعل ولا بالقلب وإن على الإنسان أن يعرف للمخلوق حقه ويقوم بما أوجب الله عليه فيه من غير غلو ولا تقصير فلا ينزل المخلوق منزلة الخالق لا بلفظه ولا بفعله ولا بقلبه فإن للخالق جل وعلا حقه المختص به لا يشركه فيه غيره وللمخلوق حقه الذي يليق به الذي أوجبه الله له لا يزاد عليه ولا ينقص منه.
الشعبي, may Allah have mercy upon him, said that when the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would meet one another, they would shake hands, and if they had returned from a journey or from traveling, then some of them would hug others. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibited bowing upon greeting, because that is a means of showing humility to a human being. And perhaps it is a means which leads to glorification of other than Allah by bowing and prostrating. And prostrating upon meeting used to be permissible in some of the previous legislations. However, this legislation, the legislation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the seal of the prophets, has prohibited it. It is the same whether that be from the point of view of greeting and showing good manners, or it is from the point of view of showing lowliness and humiliation. O people, verily it is upon the individual that he safeguard the concept of Tawheed, and he recognize the fact that the Creator has a right. So he should not fall short therein, nor should he associate other than him as a partner with him in it, neither by action nor with his heart. And verily the person, he should recognize that the creation has right, and he should establish it as Allah has made obligatory upon him without excessiveness and without falling short, so he does not put or give the creation the status of the Creator, neither by wording nor by action nor with his heart. So verily the Creator Jalla wa Ula has a right that is specific to him. He should not associate other than him as a partner with him therein, and the creation has a right which is appropriate for it, and Allah is obligated for him that he does not increase upon it, nor should he fall short therein.
أيها الإخوة, إن على الإنسان أن يعلم أنه مسؤول عما ينطق به لسانه, كما قال الله تعالى, ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد, وأنه مسؤول عما يعمله بجوارحه, كما قال الله تعالى, ولتسألن عما كنتم تعملون, وأنه مسؤول عما يكنه في ضميره, كما قال الله تعالى, أفلا يعلم إذا بعثر ما في القبور وحصل ما في الصدور. وقال تعالى يوم تبلى السرائر فما له من قوة ولا ناصر. فاتقوا الله عباد الله واشكروه على ما أنعم به عليكم من هذا الدين القويم والصراط المستقيم، واسألوه أن يثبتكم عليه إلى أن تلقوه. اللهم ارزقنا شكر نعمتك على هذا الدين القويم، وارزقنا الثبات عليه إلى أن نلقاك يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفقنا لما فيه الخير والصلاح والإصلاح، واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين المصلحين يا رب العالمين. والحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.
O brothers, verily it is upon the individual that he know that he will be questioned concerning what his tongue utters, as Allah the Exalted said, and he does not utter any word except that there is with him a recorder recording, and that the slave knows that he will be questioned concerning what he does with his limbs, as Allah the Exalted said, and you will be questioned concerning that which you used to do, and that he knows that he will be questioned concerning what he reveals or what he conceals within himself, as Allah the Exalted said, do they not know concerning the time when that which is in the grave is poured forth, and that which is in the chest will be made apparent? And Allah the Exalted said, the day where the secrets will be made known. So he will not have any strength on that day, nor any helper. So fear Allah, O slaves of Allah, and thank Him for that which He has bestowed upon you in this strong religion and this straight path, and ask Him to make you firm upon it up until the time when you meet Him. O Allah, provide us with gratitude for your favors of this strong, upright religion, and provide us with steadfastness upon it up until the time when we meet you, O Lord of all that exists. O Allah, please grant us success upon that which it contains of goodness, rectification, and uprightness, and make us from amongst your slaves who are righteous, those who rectify, O Lord of all that exists. All the praises for Allah, Lord of all that exists. May prayers and peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and upon his family and his companions and those who follow them until the day of recompense.
الحمد لله وكفى، وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، وصلى الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الحمد في الآخرة والأولى، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله المصطفى وخليله المجتبى، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن بهداه مهتدى وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فإنكم سمعتم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حمى جانب التوحيد أعظم حماية، ومنع من كل ما يكون وسيلة إلى الإشراك بالله عز وجل محبة وتعظيما، لأن محبة الله عز وجل يجب أن تكون فوق كل محبة. ثم بعد ذلك محبة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم، نحبه والله أحب إلينا من أبنائنا وأمهاتنا وآبائنا، نحبه لأنه رسول الله، فنحن نحبه لمحبة الله عز وجل.
All the praise is for Allah. All the praise is for Allah. May the prayers and peace be upon His chosen slaves. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. He is one, having no partners or equals. For him is the praise in the next life and in this life, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and his messenger, his chosen one, his beloved friend. May the prayers and peace of Allah be upon him, upon his family, and upon his companions, and those who follow in their footsteps or who are guided by their guidance. May prayers and abundant peace be upon them. As to what follows, so verily you have heard that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam safeguarded the concept of Tawheed with the greatest of safeguards, and he prevented or blocked all those means which lead to association of partners with Allah Azza wa Jal out of love and glorification for Him. Because love for Allah Azza wa Jal it is obligatory that it be over and above every other love. And then after that comes love of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We love him. And by Allah, he is more beloved to us than our sons, our mothers, and our fathers. We love him because he is the Messenger of Allah. We love him for the sake of Allah, the Mighty and Majestic.
أيها الإخوة، وإن من المهم أن يعلم الإنسان أنه لا يحل لأحد أن يعظم المخلوق أكثر مما ينبغي أن يعظم، فلا يحل لأحد أن يمشي تكريما للمخلوق على وجه ليس فيه إكرام حاضر، كما يفعل بعض الناس يمشي من محل بعيد إلى محل بعيد عند حصول نعمة لأحد أو اندفاع نقمة، فإن المشي على هذا النحو لا ينبغي إلا أن يكون لبيت الله، على أنه لا ينبغي للإنسان أن يشق على نفسه بالمشي إلى بيت الله. ولهذا لو نذر الإنسان أن يمشي إلى مكة طاعة لله عز وجل لقلنا له لا تكلف نفسك، امشي واركب، فإن الله تعالى يقول ما يفعل الله بعذابكم إن شكرتم وآمنتم. إن كل مخلوق مهما علت منزلته في الدنيا فإنه لا يستحق شيئا مما يختص الله به، وإنه لمثلك، إنه بشر، ولكنه يتميز عليه بما أنعم الله به عليه من تقوى الله عز وجل. ولهذا قال الله تعالى إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم، وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خياركم في الجاهلية خياركم في الإسلام إذا فقهوا.
O brothers, verily from that which is important is that the individual knows that it's not permissible for anyone to glorify the creation over and above that which it is proper for him to be glorified. So it's not permissible for an individual to walk for the creation in a manner which does not contain nobility, like some of the people do. They walk from one faraway place to another faraway place to attain some type of benefit for another person, or so that he may acquire something from him. So walking in this manner is not permissible except that one walk to the house of Allah. In addition to the fact that it's not proper for the person that he bring an undue hardship upon himself by walking to Mecca out of obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. So we say to him, do not overburden yourself. You can walk or you can ride. Like Allah the Exalted says, Allah will not punish you if you are grateful and you have faith. Verily, every single one from the creation, no matter what his status may be in the dunya, verily it is not befitting or proper for him in the least to have any type of special distinction. He is verily nothing but a human being like yourself. However, the people are distinguished by what have Allah bestowed upon them from taqwa, Allah Azza wa Jal. Due to this, Allah the Exalted says, verily the most honorable among you is those who have the most taqwa. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best of you in al-jahiliyyah are the best of you in al-Islam, if he gains fiqh, or understanding of the religion.
ولا شك أن الناس شعوبا وقبائل يتفاوتون، ولكن لا يجوز بأي حال من الأحوال أن نغلو في الإنسان مهما علت منزلته حتى نفعل معه مثل ما يفعل لله عز وجل، فإن حق الله خاص به وحق المخلوق خاص به. أيها الأخوة المسلمون، عظموا الله عز وجل بقلوبكم، أحبوه بقلوبكم، أحبوه لما يغدوكم به من النعم، فما بكم من نعمة فمن الله، وإذا مسكم الضر فإلى من تلجؤون؟ إنكم لن تلجؤوا إلا إلى الله عز وجل. إذن فجالب النعم وكاشف النقم هو الله عز وجل. أحبوا الله عز وجل لما هداكم فيه إلى الإيمان والتوحيد. أحبوا الله عز وجل، قوموا بطاعته محبة له. عظموا الله عز وجل، فروا من معصيته مخافة منه وخشية له. اللهم اجعلنا من أوليائك المتقين المؤمنين وحزبك المفلحين، إنك على كل شيء قدير. وأكثروا أيها الإخوة من الصلاة والسلام على نبيكم محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، فإنه الذي دلكم على كل خير ورقبكم فيه، وهو الذي بين لكم الشر وحذركم منه. واعلموا أن خير الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، كل بدعة ضلالة. فعليكم بالجماعة، فإن يد الله على الجماعة، ومن شد شد في النار.
And there is no doubt that the people are nations and tribes, and they differ and they vary. However, it is not permissible in any circumstance that we be excessive concerning the individual, no matter what his status may be in this dunya, to the point that we treat him as we treat Allah Azza wa Jal. For verily, Allah's right is for him, and verily the creation's right is for him. O brothers, O brother Muslims, glorify Allah Azza wa Jal with your hearts, love him with your hearts, and love him for what he has bestowed upon you of favors. For whatever you have of favors, it is from Allah. And if some harm were to touch you, then where would you seek refuge? You will seek refuge with none other than Allah Azza wa Jal. Hence, the one who bestows favors and the one who removes the favors, it is Allah Azza wa Jal. Love Allah Azza wa Jal for what he has guided you to of Iman and Tawheed. Love Allah Azza wa Jal. Establish his obedience and his love, and glorify Allah Azza wa Jal. Free from disobeying him out of fear of him and dread of his punishment. O Allah, make us from amongst those who are pious believers, and from amongst those who are your successful party. Verily you are able to do all things. And O brothers, increase in sending the salat and the salam upon your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For verily he is the one who has guided you. He is the one who has directed you to every good. And he is the one who has clarified the evil for you and has warned you against it. And know that the best speech is the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of a matter of matters are the newly invented matters. For every newly invented matter is an innovation. Every innovation is the misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. So it is upon you to cling to the Jama'ah, to cling to the general body of Muslims. And verily the hand of Allah, it is upon the Jama'ah, and whoever deviates from it, he deviates and he goes to the hellfire.
اللهم إنا نسألك في مقامنا هذا أن تعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وتذل الشرك والمشركين، وتدمر أعداء الدين من الكفار والمنافقين واليهود والنصارى والملحدين يا رب العالمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا، وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأوفوا بعهد الله إذا عاهدتم، ولا تنقضوا الأيمان بعد توكيدها وقد جعلتم الله عليكم كفيلا، إن الله يعلم ما تفعلون. واذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
والله we ask you in this place of ours that you give honor to Islam, to the Muslims, and that you humiliate and give humiliation to shirk and the people of shirk, and that you obliterate the enemies of the religion from the kuffar and the hypocrites, the Jews and the Christians and the atheists. O Lord of all that exists, O our Lord, we have wronged ourselves, and if you do not forgive us and have mercy upon us, then we will surely be from amongst the losers. Slaves of Allah, verily Allah commands with justice and ihsan, and he commands with giving the near relatives their rights, and he forbids from evil and foul acts, sins and iniquities. He exhorts you so that perhaps you may remember and keep the covenant of Allah once you have ratified it, and did not nullify your iman after you have affirmed it, and you have already placed Allah over you as a guarantor. Verily Allah knows all that you do. And remember Allah the Exalted, the Majestic, and He will remember you. Thank Allah for His favors, and He will give you more. And verily the remembrance of Allah is greater, and Allah knows all that you do.